today I woke up very early in the morning with a mission, or rather with one job, to harvest corn. And this is 3 months after planting, and I can say they are now ready to harvest. They are mature, and for, you know, large corn plantations, some people would prefer to use corn harvesting combines for harvesting, because it makes work easier. But in my case, because I just have a small plantation area, I decided to use a normal machete, and it gets the job done. So I would say it works for me. And since I want to immediately plant some more corn seeds or maize seeds, I therefore have to ensure, while I'm cutting off the corn stalks, I am doing some bit of, you know, clearing, especially clearing the weeds which might have grown together with the corn, so that by the time I'm done harvesting, there is little or no weeds on the plantation area, so that I can immediately plant some more corn seeds or maize seeds. After I'm done harvesting, I will carry my corn stalks to my homestead. And again, if you have so many, or rather if your corn plantation was large, you definitely need maybe a lorry or a pickup to carry or to transport your corn stalks to your homestead. But again, because my plantation area is small, I decided to carry them myself. I might go a few rounds, but yeah, I'll get the work done. After reaching the homestead, now it's time to separate the corn from the corn stalks. And if my corn is a lot, I might require help. So I might maybe employ a few people on daily wages, depending on the price we shall agree on. Or maybe if I have enough family members, they can assist me to, you know, remove or separate the corn from the corn stalks. After you're done the separation, then you now have to dry your corn, because you need to make sure your corn is really dry before consumption. So you look for maybe a polythene paper. Some people will use a polythene paper like I am doing right now. You spread it really well, and then you bring your corn there, and then spread it very well, because we want to make sure the corn is very dry. So make sure it's so well spread such that the sun is reaching every corn. And this is a process you repeat for like a couple of days for the corn to be really, really dry. After your corn is very well dried, now you can remove the corn
kernels from the cobs or from the maize cobs. You can do this using a knife, maybe. Others will use just bare hands to remove the corn kernels from the cobs. And again, if your corn is a lot, you require more people to support you, or to rather assist you with the work. Now, after removing or peeling off the kernels, you can again maybe dry them for a day or two.
And after the corn is dry, now some people will take it to the posho mill for maize flour. So that now people can maybe cook ugali with it. Others will make the white porridge. Some people will cook githeri. It's an African staple food. Githeri, very sweet if it's cooked well. So it's cooked directly using the corn kernels. Now with the corn stalks, they are very nutritious to the cows or to the cattle, especially if you have daily cows, the ones you depend on for milk. If you have a nice place set up, like the one behind me, you can use it to preserve your corn stalks, so that now you can be feeding them to your cows on daily basis, small amounts. And then you mix with Napier grass or just normal pure grass, and they make really, really nice nutritious food for your cows. You get a lot of milk from your cows. If you like my video, make sure you subscribe for more, because I'll be showing you how to plant corn seeds, potatoes, I'll show you how to plant tomatoes, cabbages, beans, sukuma wiki. There is a lot to plant. I'll show you. I'll even show you how to plant napier grass and how to maintain it to reach maturity for harvesting. That's it from me, from my crew, my brothers, my camera person for the day. I hope the video is okay. I hope the video is educative. And see you next time. Ciao.